Welcome back. We're joining Mike Eppel now, 680 News business editor. You know, we have these apps in our phone. Does it matter who really owns them?
Apparently it does. Good morning, Melissa.
Good morning.
Yeah, the talk over the weekend is the Tik Tok, which is very popular with the kids today. I have no idea how it makes any money, but it's said to be worth It's said to be worth $50 billion. Now, every time my kids show me anything on TikTok, I see no advertising. Maybe there is some, maybe there isn't. I don't know. Nevertheless, it's worth what it's said to be worth in the eyes of these social media companies and you know, the possible buyout of TikTok, which is owned by ByteDance out of China, which has run afoul of the Trump administration because the accusation has been that China is using these apps as a conduit for data mining and spying. It's all back and forth in the political spectrum.
Yep.
Trump has talked about banning TikTok and WeChat within 45 days from doing business with American companies. So there is the precursor to a deal to be had. So now Twitter, which is worth $29 billion, could be buying TikTok, which is said to be worth $50 billion. So there's a lot of work to do to get that circle squared, so to speak. Microsoft was said to be a front runner for TikTok as of last week. They certainly do have the financial wherewithal to do a deal, but it'll be interesting to see who buys it. And the other thing, too, is will it be as popular today in 6 months
yeah.
or a year? What, you know, trends are... technology is fickle, you know, when it comes to these apps, and it'll be interesting to see exactly how this plays out and whether or not it'll be a moneymaker.
And so many of these apps are becoming more and more like each other, too. So it's hard to kind of differentiate between them.
Well, again, Instagram is coming out with its own short-form video competitor to TikTok. Snap is out there. All these other things that might, you know, all of a sudden be popular, and TikTok may go by the wayside.
A lot of billions
not.
On
Who
a
knows?
Trend. The
Who
future
knows?
Of shopping malls. Things are going to change.
Yes. The talk this morning is that Amazon is looking to buy up space in shopping malls in the United States because we've seen some of the biggest names in retail go by the wayside just in the past few years. Sears. You know, a lot of Sears stores are left empty. They're in Canada, too, to some extent, but they're not. They're just talking about the U.S., properties of Simon Properties, a huge shopping mall operator in the U.S. Amazon could buy up space at an old Sears location or a JCPenney or some of these other historic names in retail that are now left empty because Amazon needs the space for fulfillment centers.
Okay, so you wouldn't be going there to
storing.
Shop.
No, but they'd use it for a distribution center. So wouldn't that be a turn of events if, in fact, Amazon, which, of course, is the biggest player in e-commerce, uses a traditional shopping mall property to grow its business that much further.
Now, spotlight on gold. What's happening there this week?
Yep. Well, we've seen gold hit a record high most recently, north of $2,000 an ounce. And Barrick, one of the world's largest gold producers, based here in Toronto, will be reporting earnings today. And it'll be interesting to hear if Barrick uses this gold rally to say, hey, all of these mines that have been sitting stagnant for years because it wasn't economical to pull gold out of the ground. It was just too expensive. Can they now restart mining operations? That's a lot of talk this year, actually, that these mining outfits are saying, we can make money at these levels. So does that lead to a new boom time, a gold rush, as it were, in the mining sector? And Barrick, again, reports results today.
And no surprise, a time of uncertainty, we're talking about gold. That seems to happen all the time.
Well, yeah, and that and the fact that the U.S. has printed about $4 trillion of American greenbacks just to help stabilize the economy, that's probably going to lead to some currency devaluation, and the gold bug's keying on that.
Nice chatting with you this morning, Mike.